Yo, what's good, guys? It's Nightwing2303 from WearTesters.com. Big thank you to everybody over at Puma and Puma Hoops for sending these guys over. For those of you that don't know, this is the upcoming Puma Clyde Court Disrupt. Now, they came in this crazy box that it's just a basic box, but it's got this big Puma cat drawn on there. Puma on the side and all that stuff, and it was actually closed with one of these weird ratchet systems, and I thought that that was pretty interesting. Inside, there was the shoes, obviously. There's some cards for, like, promo stuff, making sure that you have the right social handles and, you know, like, saying, hey, Chris, enjoy, and all that kind of good things. That doesn't make sense. All that kind of good things. All those kinds of good things. Additionally, there was this guy right here, which is a disposable camera, I believe. There's that. It smells old school. It looks old school. And basically, I'm supposed to take pictures and stuff, and then I put it back in the envelope and send it back to them. I don't know what they're going to do with the images, but hopefully I can, you know, make some cool ones.
The card tells you exactly what to do.
Does it really?
Yes.
What does it say?
It says to take pictures of you opening everything up. You get 24 images, you put it back in the envelope, send it to them, and then they're going to upload it all, and then you can go in and you can pull your pictures and use them, and hopefully, like, your pictures are good enough and they'll use them too.
Use my pictures of what? Unboxing the shoe?
Yeah.
But I'm making a video about it.
No, I know, but they want...
I can just watch it. Okay, well, I'm not going to do that. I'm going to do my own thing because, you know, that's just what I do. I don't follow instructions. I don't listen to rules. Nightwing knows best, most of the time.
It's interactive.
Well, I'm going to be interactive. I'm going to have, like, you know what I mean? So this is my first kind of, like, in-hand look at them. I got them yesterday and I've already played in them. I'm going to try my best not to give any performance spoilers just because it was just one simple night for a few hours. But the traction on them did not disappoint. You can kind of see how much dust and whatnot is caked on the bottom of these things. I did have to wipe periodically, but not anything crazy. So I was actually very surprised with them. And I know that they look super bottom heavy and clunky, but they did not actually feel like that, which was very surprising to me because I played in setups that look like this. I played in setups that are similar to this and I've never loved them or really enjoyed them. These guys, I didn't not like them. I just, you know, it wasn't anything like, oh my gosh, this is crazy. But at the same time, they don't feel how they look. They did not feel clunky or anything like that. They're also very bottom heavy, and again, they did not feel like that while I was playing in them. The upper is pretty light, so I think it kind of balanced it out a little bit. And despite this being all rubber, it's actually real flexible, which is really cool. So again, it looks heavy, it looks clunky, it feels like that in hand, but on foot, it's not like that. It's actually pretty comfortable. Now inside the midsole, it's Puma's energy beads, which is something that we've seen on previous models. And we also have seen that on the Puma Hybrid, which featured energy and their Ignite foam. Now these things, I think that they're loose because they look like that they're loose, but they also don't jostle at all when you, like, move it. So I'm almost positive that the internal midsole is very similar to this little Puma cat right here and the Puma Hybrid, where it was the beads within the foam and all that stuff. So it is one, like, foam slab of midsole. And when I lifted up the insole, you can actually see the impression after I started wearing them and everything. So again, I think that this is a midsole within this, like, rubber cup sole. Again, I didn't feel like it was anything outstanding, but at the same time, I never felt like I was feeling the floor underneath me in terms of impact. So while I had court feel, I didn't literally feel the court, which I think is pretty interesting. So for a foam cushion that I've never really used before, from a performance perspective, I was actually impressed with them. Now the upper is really nice, actually. I was very surprised because knits are something that I'm super tired of because either they work or they don't. And when they don't, I get real frustrated because it's just like, how many times are we gonna go through this? You know what I mean? But this one right here, it actually works. It feels good as well. It is backed by some kind of soft material, but whatever the material is, it allows the knit to be knit without being stretched. So it moves and all that stuff and flexes with your foot naturally, but it does not overstretch like something like the KD11. Visually, I think that these look way better in person and on foot. I know that images of this shoe in this particular colorway look kind of jarring. They're super neon, they're super bright, but on foot, they're actually kind of fresh. So I was, again, surprised. Now the collar area and the tongue is a compression-like sock. This is the one section of the shoe that is very stretchy and knit-like. And then underneath that is actually a layer of padding, which is really cool. So I was able to really tighten up these laces without any lace pressure. Lockdown, I had no issues so far, but again, I'm not gonna get into the performance aspects. I'll wait till I'm done testing them and then I'll give you guys the performance review in a couple of weeks. The rear section of the shoe does feature leather, a little bit of a throwback to the old school models, the Puma Suedes and the Clydes. And then we have a TPU heel counter right there with the Puma logo. The rear section of the shoe where your heel is heavily padded and contoured, so it's a nice little like feeling around your heel. It feels like any other shoe that you would get for basketball, which I think is great. And overall, I'm very impressed with the shoe so far, just in my short time playing in them. I cannot wait to play in them again. Not only are they extremely bright, but they are one of those like shoes that you wear on court and everybody's kind of like, yo, like what the hell are you wearing right now? Why are they so bright? Didn't know Puma still made basketball shoes. I didn't even know Puma made basketball shoes in the first place. People are very intrigued and I think that this is awesome. The release date is going to be October 1st. The retail price should be about $120. Stay tuned for the performance review, sound off below, and let us know what you guys think about these after this quick first look. Once again, thank you to everybody over at Puma and Puma Hoops for sending these over. We greatly appreciate it. And again, thank you guys so much for watching. So until next time, guys, have a good one.